We're honored to be joined today by two U.S. Olympians from Plymouth and great hockey talents, Kelly Pannek and Dani Cameranesi. And well, tell us what this last couple months has been like. I mean, it's got to be one of the most amazing experiences of your life. What's it been like?
Yeah, at the beginning, it was a lot of traveling. We went straight from South Korea to L.A., went on the Ellen Show, went to a Kings game there, went back to Tampa where we've been training for the last 6 months as a team, went to a Lightning game. And then from there, we went to D.C., New York, got to do a lot of really cool things, like on the Jimmy Fallon Show. It was really fun. And then since we've been back, I've been back now for probably like a week and a half or so, just kind of doing stuff in the community. Yesterday, I went to my high school, which was really fun, to spend a day with them.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's basically just been a whirlwind of stuff, going all over the place, getting to meet and see a lot of cool people, and I think especially for me, being back home has been the most rewarding, and bringing it back to our community and all the people who, like, helped us and supported us, and that part has been probably most exciting, and just seeing all the love that we've gotten from everyone, it's been incredible.
There's so much build up to the Olympics, and then did the games themselves seem to go by fast, or what was the actual Olympic experience like?
Yeah, I feel like fast and slow. I feel like sometimes it felt like it was just like flying by, and then sometimes you're like, oh, I feel like I want it to be like the last game. But yeah, I think once we were there, it was really big focus for our team to treat it like another tournament. There are times to take in the full Olympic experience, like when we had a walk in opening ceremonies, that was really fun. But then other times, like when we were approaching our games, just treat it as another game.
Yeah, it was, I feel like it was kind of long, but like she said, there are times where it just kind of flew by. I think it really hit me in the closing ceremonies when the torch went out. It was like my heart almost broke. I'm like, it's actually over. Like, waited my whole life to be here, and it's actually ending, but it couldn't have ended in a better way. And for us, the journey has still continued afterwards. So we're still making our marks and making our rounds. So that part's been really fun.
I'm sure growing up, you know, it seemed like Blake Breck was a huge rivalry, and then Minnesota-Wisconsin or Benilde versus Minnetonka for you. But how about USA versus Canada? What is that rivalry like from the inside?
I think it's one of the best rivalries out there. People keep asking me if the game was as intense as it looked. And I was like, yeah, it's one of the most intense games I played in, and people are really surprised and ecstatic about the game itself and how great it was. And the rivalry definitely is there. It's the biggest rivalry I think I've ever played in throughout high school and college, and I guess it's speaks for itself. It's on the biggest world stage, and you're fighting for your country, basically. So
yeah, I think the dynamics actually are really similar to like what you experience with, I mean, Minnesota, Wisconsin, or even some high school rivalries, just because you know some of the girls on the other team. Yeah. So it's kind of weird because for our sport, like, you all somehow kind of cross paths in some way. For us, we didn't have any teammates, like college teammates, on the Canadian team, so it was a little different, but other people on our team did. So in that way, it's kind of weird, but yeah, I mean, it's so intense, and I think it's because you know you have to beat the other to get to your ultimate goal. And that's why I think, like Dani said, the game was as intense as it seems.
Dani, you had a great tournament. Kelly, you assist on the goal that sends it to overtime. Talk about your own personal experiences as players, you know, within the tournament. Were you happy with the way things went for yourselves, too?
Yeah. I was ecstatic with Kelly's pass up to Monique. Yeah, she had a great tournament, and I think as a team, we all had a great tournament, and that kind of shows how we ended up at our ultimate goal and winning the gold medal. If everyone weren't playing at their top level, then that likely wouldn't have been the outcome that we got. So it was a really great experience, something we've been looking forward to our whole lives, and for it to actually flourish and come to life and our dreams finally came true, it doesn't get much better than that.
Yeah, I mean, she almost got a hat trick against Nora, who, I mean, is arguably one of the best goalies in the world, and she hates getting scored on by Gophers, so that was really fun to watch. I wish she would have gotten the third, but like she said, I think our whole team, I mean, just did so well and was so balanced. We had scoring from Gigi, who is the oldest player on the team, and had a great tournament. So, yeah, it was just fun to see everyone succeed and be put in, you know, the right positions. And it was really, honestly, just so fun to be a part of that team.
Hockey is obviously a big focus of the Olympics, but also a lot of great performances by other U.S. athletes. Did you get a chance to experience that much?
A few, yeah, a little bit. I mean, our tournament goes the whole time, so it's kind of an off day here or there. But my personal favorite was we went to the gold medal curling match for the men. And that was so fun because we had seen those guys and they're so chill just around the village, and they were really big fans of our team and really friendly. So it was really fun to be able to cheer them on. And I mean, being in that arena for that sports moment was so cool.
Yeah, a number of us got to go to different ones. Like she said, we all went to the gold medal curling match, and that was so awesome. Went to figure skating and speed skating, and just honestly having the Olympics on the television the entire time was so cool, seeing such high-level athletes compete in their sports. And we're sitting there. These people are doing death-defying things. Like, it is incredible. We don't really know what's going on in some of the sports, but the things that people do are so cool.
The world's so connected now, obviously. While you were in South Korea, did you have an idea what kind of reaction your team was getting here in the Twin Cities?
A little bit afterwards. Yeah. My family got together at a restaurant and watched with a bunch of family, friends, whoever. They just kind of opened the invite to a lot of different people. So being able to see that like video afterwards of them all cheering and like staying up when we won in the shootout was really cool. But I mean, during, I didn't even really think about it during, but afterwards it was definitely like really cool to see how, you know, just our families back here and friends back here reacted.
Yeah, definitely got a few videos and a bunch of texts after that last game, but I think it kind of hit us when we came back to the States. And I think the LA Kings game was where it was really like, wow, all these people really were watching the entire time and supporting us, because we were walking through the rink and everyone was like lining up, giving us high fives, cheering. And I guess I didn't realize how far our game reached out to people and really brought everyone together. And just to bring attention to women's hockey in general, I think was a big thing for us.
Has fame been hard to adjust to a little bit?
Fame might be a little much.
No, I was actually out with Hannah and Lee for St. Patrick's Day, and people were like coming up to us and were like, you guys were Olympians, right? I'm like, how do you guys actually know who we are? That part's been a little weird for me. And I even went to shopping with my mom, and someone came up to us, and I think it was Athleta, and we're like, there's a gold medalist in the store. I'm like, how do you people know who I am? So that part's been weird, but really cool.
Yeah, I'm ready for it to like die down a little bit, but yeah, I mean, there's the random stuff like that. And then what we really enjoy is just being able to reach out to the young girls, the young boys that, you know, come see us, whether they recognize us in an airport. Once this little girl like came over, was like, can I get your autograph? And we're like, sure, like absolutely. But yeah, that's what's been really cool, is just kind of seeing how like these young people, these young kids, just react to us. And I mean, they don't even necessarily know who we are, but they just know that like that's really cool. So that's been really fun.
Yeah, there were a very long line, steady stream at the Plymouth Ice Center over the weekend. You know, was that a fun thing to see? I know a lot of people that came up you recognize from your past and things too. Was that pretty cool to see?
Yeah, I think it was cool to see all of the young kids. Like she said, that was one of our main goals and intent, is to grow the game and kind of inspire young children and young kids to follow their dreams, whatever it may be. So that has been really cool. And when people come up to us and are like, when did you start skating? Because they might want to start skating for the first time. And they're like, okay, you started skating when you're five, and I started when I'm five. So like, I have a chance to make it there. And like she said, I went to my elementary school yesterday too, and everyone was so excited. All the little kids were like, Danny's here. Like, don't know if they really know who I am, but yeah, just inspiring young kids. And a lot of them came through for us, and I think it went 3 hours maybe, and it was only set up for two, and people waited in line for 2 hours, which was incredible.
Yeah, everyone just wants to see the gold medal too.
Yeah.
That's been really fun, is just how many people, like, I mean, adults even, I think, they're always like, ones like, guys, do you want to touch, like, see if you can touch their medal? And like, we're obviously really happy to share it with everyone, and everyone's always shocked by how heavy it is, but that's been really fun to see too, is just how, it's not even so much about our sport. And sometimes it is, and that's great, and we really like want to push that our sport deserves that. But at the same time, it's the Olympics, so that's what's, I think, gets everyone's attention, is that it's something that's so big and so many people watch. And so many people, I mean, never have seen a gold medal before, so to be able to share it with people that, you know, are just so excited for you, for your sport, for your team, and also just for this gold medal is really fun.
What's coming next hockey-wise? I think Kelly's answer might be a little easier, to more straightforward, but what's coming up for you?
Yeah, I go back to the Gophers. I have one more year of school, one more year playing with them, so I'm really excited just to see what the season looks like, how it turns out, and get back with that team.
Dani, you're done with the Gophers, but what's next for you?
Unfortunately, done with the Gophers. I wish I had an opportunity to go back there, but I think for a lot of us, we're taking a little time off vacationing because we've been working really hard for the past 4 years and our entire lives. But yeah, so taking a little break, and then I'll probably get back to training, and I'll be really fortunate if I had a chance to be on the team again. Like Kelly and multiple other people have said, and it's not always our choice, but I'll be very lucky, and I'm young, I'm only 22, so for another 4 years would be amazing.
Well, hopefully that comes and happens for both of you. Congratulations again, and thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. Yeah.